بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تمسك بسنته بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. فAfter praising Allah سبحانه وتعالى and sending the salutations upon the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام and upon his family and his companions and upon all those who follow upon his guidance into the establishment of the last day, to proceed, ikhwan, فنقدم إليكم بإذن الله تعالى شرحا لفضيلة الشيخ الإمام الشيخ صالح ابن فوزان الفوزان حفظه الله وسلمه الله من كل سوء ومكروه. So we present to you, ikhwan, the explanation of the eminent Imam, the Shaykh Al-Allama, الشيخ صالح ابن فوزان الفوزان, وهو يشرح كتابا عظيم وهو شرح السنة للإمام أبي محمد إمام البربهاري رحمه الله تعالى رحمه الله تعالى. And he is explaining, ya إخوان, a tremendous work that has been authored and put forth by the great Imam Abu Muhammad al-Barbahari رحمه الله تعالى رحمه الله تعالى. تفضل.
رحيم. مكتبة العلم الصحيح بالجزائر العاصمة أقدم لكم هذه المادة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, وصلى الله وسلم على عبده ورسوله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. قال الإمام أبو محمد الحسن بن علي بن فلك البربهاري في كتابه شرح السنة, الحمد لله الذي قد.
So one of the students begins by reading the introduction by Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah ta'ala upon our noble Shaykh, Shaykh Salih al-Fawzan, and he begins by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending the salutation upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. He says Imam al-Barbahari begins by saying Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lil-Islam. He says that, he says, all praise belong to Allah, the one who has guided us to the religion of al-Islam. And Sheikh Fawzan begins as he says.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in.
So he begins by sending the praise upon Allah Ta'ala, the Lord of all the worlds, and by sending the prayers and peace upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam, our Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam, and upon his family and his companions collectively.
هذا الكتاب مؤلفه البربهاري واسمه الحسن بن علي بن خلف البربهاري.
So he says this book here has been authored by the Imam al-Barbahari, may Allah have mercy upon him, and his name is al-Hasan ibn Ali ibn Khalaf al-Barbahari.
يشبه إلى بربهار وهو نوع من الأدوية.
He says, and as for the name al-Barbahari, he is attributed to al-Barbahar, and he says, and this is a type of medicine or some sort.
لعله كان يشتغل بها أو يبيعها فنسب إليها.
He says, حفظه الله تعالى, that Imam al-Barbahari, he says, perhaps he used to busy himself with this medicine, he said, or perhaps he used to sell it, he says, so therefore he was attributed to it. And he is from the great scholars, the major scholars from the Hanbali Madhab. Translator's note, the Madhab of Al-Imami Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah ta'ala rahimahullah ta'ala.
أخذ عمن أخذ عن الإمام أحمد مثل المروذي وغيره.
He says, an Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah, he took knowledge from the students of Al-Imam Ahmad. He took knowledge from the students of Al-Imam Ahmad. The likes of Imam al-Marwudi, Imam al-Marwudi, like Imam al-Marwudi and other than him, rahimahumullah.
ك تبحر في العلم، أخذ العقيدة وأخذ الفقه وأخذ العلم عن كبار الأئمة.
So he says this great Imam, he was an ocean of knowledge. He took knowledge from the science of al-aqidah, the belief system of al-Islam, and he took knowledge from al-fiqh, the science of the jurisprudence of al-Islam, and he took knowledge from the major imams of this ummah, the major imams of this ummah.
مراد بالسنة هنا الطريقة.
He says in here when he says شرح السنة, the explanation of the Sunnah, the explanation of the Sunnah. He says the intent here with the word Sunnah is طريقة, is the way.
طريقة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
He says meaning the طريقة الرسول, the way, the method, that which the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام was upon. The tariqatu rasul, the path of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu wa salam.
Tariqatu rasul laysa al-murad biha al-mustalah 'ind al-muhaddithin.
He says here the intent is not the same intent that the scholars of al-hadith, the term that they use, the meaning that they use when these scholars of al-hadith say the word sunnah. This is not the intent here with the book sharh sunnah.
إنه ما ثبت عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من قول أو فعل أو تقرير.
And the intent that these scholars use, meaning the scholars of al-hadith, when they say sunnah, is أنه ما ثبت أو ما ثبت عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام من قول أو فعل أو تقرير. He says, حفظه الله, when the scholars of hadith, they intend by sunnah that which has been authentically collected upon the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam from his statements and from actions and from those things that was done in front of him and he gave his silent approval with regards to. But the intent here with the word sharh sunnah, the explanation of the sunnah, he says here the intent here is a more general intent.
وطريقة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وطريقة أصحابه وطريقة السلف الصالح.
He says, in this general intent, once again, by the word شرح السنة, is the way, the path of the Messenger of Allah alayhi salatu salam, and the way or the path of his companions radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim, and the path of those rightly guided predecessors. He says this is the sunnah al-ma'thura, the sunnah that has been narrated,
سواء في الاعتقاد او في العباده او في الفقه او في الاداب والأخلاق, كل هذا يسمى بالسنة حيث العموم.
He says, and this encompasses the al-i'tiqad, the belief system of the Muslim, of al-Islam, and it also is the same, it entails also the issues of al-ibadat, the issues of worship, and it also entails the issues of al-fiqh, the issues of the jurisprudence of al-Islam, and it entails also the manners and conduct and character. All of this is given the word sunnah with a more general meaning.
ومعنى شرح أي بيان, ليس معناه أنه يشرح كتاب معين.
He says in the meaning when the author says sharh, as he says the explanation of the sunnah, so the meaning of the word sharh, explanation here, is bayan, a clarification. He says it does not have the meaning that this is the explanation of a particular book. This is not the intent here. He says it is not the intent that he is explaining a particular book.
أنه يوضح الطريقة طريقة السنة.
He says rather, Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan, he says, حفظه الله, but rather the intent here is that the author is clarifying, he is illustrating, he is making it clear the path of the sunnah, the way of the sunnah.
هذا معنى شرح السنة.
This is the meaning when the author says شرح السنة, the explanation of the sunnah.
كانوا في الأول يسمون كتب العقيدة يسمون السنة.
He says, and you find the imams of the past, from the earlier generations, rahimahum Allah, you find that they have given, or they would give, books that covered the science of aqidah, the title of a sunnah. They will call these books, books of aqidah, books of the sunnah.
مثل هذا الكتاب سنة للإمام أحمد, السنة لابن عبد الله,
he says, an example of this is like the book we have in front of us, the book Sharh al-Sunnah. Also like the book by Al-Imam Ahmad, his Usul al-Sunnah, the foundations of the Sunnah. Like the book of As-Sunnah by his son, Abdullah. He has a book called As-Sunnah. Like the book As-Sunnah by Imam Al-Athram. He also has a book called As-Sunnah.
أصول السنة أو شرح أصول السنة لللالكائي سمون العقيدة بالسنة.
He says similarly the book by the great Imam اللالكائي رحمه الله in his book is called شرح أصول اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة. In his book is the explanation of the fundamentals of the belief of the people of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah.
ويسمونها الإيمان. يسمونها الإيمان.
He says, and also you find these Imams of the past, they would also give their books the title of Al-Iman, the books of belief.
في بعض الكتب كتاب الإيمان.
So in some of the books you find that they were called Kitab al-Iman. They were given the title, the Book of Iman, the Book of Belief.
وهذا كما هو موجود في صحيح البخاري ومسلم. يعقدون كتابا يسمونه كتاب الإيمان.
And you find the example of this, like in the Sahih of Al-Imam al-Bukhari, and in the Sahih of Al-Imam Muslim, رحمهم الله, that they would mention a particular book from their Sahih, and called this particular book كتاب الإيمان, كتاب الإيمان, the book of belief.
يريدون فيه ما يختص بالعقيدة, إيمان بالله وما يتبع ذلك.
He says, and in these books they were mentioned those affairs that were particular and specific, that would cover the issues of al-aqidah, those affairs that were connected to the belief of Allah and His angels, and that which would follow that. The belief of Allah and His angels and His books and His messengers, and the belief in the last day and the qadr, it's good and it's bad.
الإيمان.
They will call these books books of Iman.
وقد يسمونها الشريعة كما في كتاب الشريعة للإمام الأجري الشافعي.
And also you find these great Imams of the past, رحمهم الله, they would also give their books the title of شريعة, the legislation of Al-Islam, like what was done by the great Imam الأجري الشافعي رحمه الله. As he has a book that he is given the title, the Book of Sharia. He says, and here there's no contradiction with regards to the titles here, with regard to these examples, but this was with regards to those names that were different in expressions or lettering, but they carried the same meaning. They are synonyms to one another. He says, so every term has its angle. He says, and there's no difference of opinion in this regard. So although these particular titles may differ in their expressions or in their lettering, but in reality, they carry the same meanings. They are synonyms to one another. They are synonyms to one another.
وقد يسمى التوحيد مثل التوحيد لابن خزيمة كتب التوحيد معروفة سمى العقيدة وما يعتقده القلب.
He says, and also you find that these great imams, they would give their books the title of التوحيد, meaning the oneness of Allah Ta'ala, like what was done by the great imam Ibn Khuzaymah in his book At-Tawheed, the book of Tawheed, and those other famous well-known books, they were given the title of At-Tawheed, meaning Aqidah. And he says sometimes they were given the meaning, or they were given the title of Aqidah, those affairs that the heart believes in. Those affairs that the heart believes in and worships Allah Ta'ala based upon and is certain and absolute with regards to. So these names here, oh my brothers, they are synonyms to one another. In reality, there are no differences within these particular words. They are different names, they are various names that point to one and the same thing. So they are from synonyms. He says, however, what you find from many of the people of today, those that try to bring tashkik, they try to bring doubt among the Muslims. And they claim that as for Aqidah and as for At-Tawheed, the belief of Al-Islam and the oneness of Allah Ta'ala, they try to come and bring some doubt. And they say this or these expressions have no proofs from the Quran. You cannot find Aqidah, you cannot find Tawheed, the words of them, in the Quran. He says this was done by these individuals who tried to bring doubt. So they come with the likes of this type of speech. These individuals that try to bring doubt, ya ikhwan, what do? They come and say Aqidah, the word Aqidah is not in the Quran, nor is it in the Sunnah. The word Tawheed is not in the Quran, nor is it in the Sunnah. They are trying to bring doubt to the people. He says, but the meaning in reality, the meanings of Aqidah and the meaning of a Tawheed is found and mentioned in the Quran and in the Sunnah. But these individuals, once again, they want to bring doubt to the people with regards to one's belief. And they do this why? They do this because they don't want the people to be able to differentiate and to have the distinction between those astray groups, those deviated groups, and between those, or the group that is sound and upright and upon istiqamah and righteousness. So this is the intent, this is what they're trying to do here.
ومن أجل أن لا يرد على أهل الباطل.
And another reason they do this is so that the people of falsehood will not be refuted. The people of falsehood will not be corrected and refuted.
هذا قصد.
So this is their intent.
هذا قصد المتعلمين منهم وأما الهمج والرعاع الذين يأخذون من المجادل الأفكار هم يرددون هذه الأقوال.
So this is the intent of those who teach from among them. This is their intent here. They want to bring doubt to the people. But as for those who take their ideologies from the Mazabil al-Afkari, he says they are the ones who they repeat and re-mention and mention the likes of these statements. And they have an intent by that. Wa alaykum salam. He says, and you find this in some of their books, some of the compilations. He says, you find that in their books, they do not call them mu'allafat. They do not call them compilations. But rather, they are mazabil.
وهذه الأمور وهذا شيء درجت عليه الأمة.
So he says, but as for the ruling of this, it is not allowed for the individual to turn towards the likes of these doubts. It is not allowed to turn towards the likes of these doubts regarding these affairs.
واهتموا به تمييزا بين الحق والباطل.
He says, and this is something that the Ummah of Al-Islam has made or is present with regards to one's daraja. And the Ummah, the people of Al-Islam, has to give great consideration to be ordered to distinguish between the truth and to distinguish between the falsehood. And to be able to distinguish between guidance and to be able to distinguish between misguidance.
هم يريدون أن يدمجوا الناس ولا يكون هناك فارق بين ملحد وزنديق ومستقيم ومبتدع تحت مظلة اسم الإسلام.
So he says, and once again, they do not want to, the people to be able to distinguish between the truth and falsehood. But there's a difference between the mulhid and the zindiq, the one who is an atheist and one who has left Islam, والمستقيم ومبتدع, and the one who is upon righteousness and istiqama, following the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, and the one who is upon innovation. There's a grave difference. So these individuals, they don't want the people to be able to distinguish between these affairs. And they say, in order to keep the Muslims together, united together. However, the Muslims will never be unified. The Muslims will never be unified except under the correct belief. That the Muslims will never be unified unless these Muslims are together upon the sound and correct belief.
جمعت الصحابة وكانوا متفرقين.
And this is the thing that united the companions of the Messenger of Allah رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. And they were once divided, but the thing that brought them together, the thing that unified them was
ثم أعداء تألف بين قلوبكم. مش اللي جمع بين الصحابة.
So he says, and the thing that united the companions was the correct belief. They were upon the sound, correct methodology. As Allah Ta'ala says, translator's note, as it comes in Surah Ali Imran. As Allah Ta'ala says, وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَاصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَةِ إِخْوَانًا. Surah Ali Imran. As Allah Ta'ala says, and remember the bounty of Allah, the favor of Allah upon you. When you used to be enemies to one another, فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ, and then He, meaning Allah, united your hearts, فَاسْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَةِ إِخْوَانًا, and then you became, by His blessing upon you, brothers and sisters to one another. So Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan, he says, so what is the thing that gathered and united the companions upon the Messenger, the companions of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam? What is the thing that united them from deviation, or rather from being divided, from separation? What is the thing that united them from this separation? The thing was nothing except this correct belief. And this belief is the meaning that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah, and that Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah. So nothing unites the people except the aqidah to sahiha, except the correct methodology, the correct belief. But as long as the people are divided and different, or they are different with regards to their methodology and their belief, then they will never, ever, ever be unified. He says, yes, differences of opinion takes place in the science of al-fiqh. He says, however, but it will never lead to mother separation. It will never lead to enmity and hatredness ever. He says, the ikhtilaf, the difference of opinion in the issues of al-fiqh, then this ikhtilaf is ijtihadun sa'irun. It is an allowed ijtihad. It is an allowed efforts that the people put forth. But when it comes to the issues of aqidah, then this is غَيْرُ السَّائِغُ, then this is not allowed. And those that are different, that differ with regards to one's aqidah, one's belief, they will never ever be unified together, because their belief is not upon the belief of the correct belief. As long as their belief is different, then they will never be unified. So the people who they differ in their belief, in their aqidah, they will never ever be unified together. They will never be in harmonization, no matter who tries to unify them and who tries to unify them. They will never be unified because their beliefs are different. He says, because the person is trying to unify between two things that are in opposition to one another. And it is impossible to bring two opposing things together, to unify two things that are mutadaddat, that are in opposition to one another. It is impossible to bring these things in harmonization. Things that oppose one another, it is impossible to unite them. So, for the individuals who want to bring the unity of the Muslims, then what's upon them is for them to correct their belief first and foremost.
العقيدة التي كان الرسل من أولهم إلى آخرهم يهتمون بها ويبدأون بها.
The belief that the messengers from the first of them, and the belief that the messengers from the last of them, that they gave great consideration to, and that they began with عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
عليهم أن يوحدوها أولا.
So it is upon these individuals that they bring the people together, first and foremost, upon the correct methodology, that they single out Allah Ta'ala in His worship, upon a Tawheed. So if the people come together, and they are upon the same methodology, and their belief is one belief, now اتحدت الأمة. Now the Ummah will become unified. He says, if they are, they strive and they are upon correctness and they are truthful and they are truthful in their claim. He says, however, but now the people, they are making a mockery. And when they speak about aqidah, nowadays, when the people call to the belief of Islam, the people who are making a mockery, they say, look, these individuals, they are making takfir of the Muslims. They are deeming Muslims to be disbelievers. They say this one wants to make divisions and to separate the Muslims. And they say this and they say that to the end of what they say. He says, but we say to them that based upon what you are saying, you will never be able to unify the Muslims ever. You will never be able to do so. He says, however, if the Muslims come together upon their belief, if their belief is one, the belief of the messengers of Allah Ta'ala, they have the belief, the correct sound methodology, now the Muslims will be unified, and this will happen with ease. As Allah Ta'ala, He says in His glorious book, translator's note, this comes in Surah 2 Al-Anfal. Allah Ta'ala says, هو الذي أيدك بنصره وبالمؤمنين وألف بين قلوبهم لو أنفقت ما في الأرض جميعا ما ألفت بين قلوبهم ولكن الله ألف بينهم إنه عزيز حكيم. As Allah Ta'ala says, and He, meaning Allah, He is the one that has aided you, O Muhammad, with His help and His aid and His support. And He also aided those who believe. And He allafa bayna qulubihim, and He united, He brought their hearts together. He united their hearts. And if you were to spin from all of the earth, or from that which is upon the earth, all of it, you will never be able to unify their hearts. However, it is Allah that has brought their hearts together. Innahu Azizun Hakim, and verily He is the All Powerful and the All Wise. And Allah Ta'ala says, translator's note, as it comes in Surah Ali Imran, Allah Ta'ala says, وَذْكُرُ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ, and remember the bounty of Allah upon you. إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً, when you used to be enemies to one another, and He brought your hearts together. فَاسْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَةِ إِخْوَانًا, and then you became, by His bounty and grace upon you, brothers and sisters to one another. وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَى حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا, and remember you were on the brinks of the hellfire, and He, meaning Allah, rescued you and saved you from the fire. Thus, this is how Allah makes clear to you His ayat, His signs, His evidence, His verses, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ, so that you will be guided. Surah 2 Ali Imran. So the people will never be unified. It will never be upon harmonization except by way of the correct authentic methodology, belief of Al-Islam.
التي جاءت بها الرسل من أولهم إلى خاتمهم محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And this is the thing that the messengers of Allah had come with from the first of them to the last of them, Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام.
أرسلنا من قبلك من رسول إلا نوحي إليه أنه لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدون.
As Allah Ta'ala says, translators note, as it comes in Surah Al-Anbiya, Allah Ta'ala says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَعَبُدُونَ. As Allah Ta'ala says, and we, meaning Allah, have not sent before you, O Muhammad, from the messengers, except that we have revealed upon him, sent down upon him, revealed upon him, then none has the right to be worshipped except me, meaning Allah. So therefore worship me.
وإن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاتقون.
And as Allah Ta'ala says, translators note, as it comes in Surah Al-Mu'minun, Allah Ta'ala says, he says, and verily this, وإن هذه أمتكم أمة واحدة وأنا ربكم فاتقون. And Allah Ta'ala says, and verily this, Ummah of yours is one Ummah, is one nation, and I am your Lord. And I, meaning Allah, am your Lord, so therefore fear me. And as it comes in another verse, translators note, as it comes in Surah Al-Anbiya, إِنَّ هَذِي أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَعَبُدُونَ. As Allah Ta'ala says, verily this Ummah of yours is one Ummah, and I am your Lord, so therefore worship me. Surah Al-Anbiya.
على عبادة الله ما يتوحدون إلا على عبادة رب واحد.
So the people will never come together upon harmonization except that they come together upon the worship of one Lord.
عبادة رب واحد وهو الله سبحانه وتعالى لأنه هو الرب الحق.
He says they will never come together except upon the worship of one Lord, one deity, one God, and he is Allah, the mighty and the glorious, because he is the Rabbul Haqq, he is the true Lord, and whatever is worshipped besides him is false. As Allah Ta'ala says, as it comes in Surah Al-Hajj, ذلك بأن الله هو الحق وأن ما يدعون من دونه هو الباطل وأن الله هو العزيز الكبير. As Allah Ta'ala says, and that is because Allah, he is the true deity, and what you call upon besides him is false, and Allah is Al-Ali Al-Kabir, he is the most high and he is the most great.
فهذا هو مجال توحيد المسلمين إن كانوا صادقين.
So this is the affair that unites the Muslims, that will bring the oneness or the unification of the Muslims if the people are truthful. So it is upon them to correct their belief and their methodology and to deny for themselves zayr wa dakhil, misguidance and deviation.
كما جاء بها محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم أن المسلمين يتحدون عليه.
He says that which the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام has come with, or in order for them to be upon that which the messenger of Allah has come with, and then with this the Muslims will be united and they will be amongst or upon harmonization and harmony.
وهذا الذي أراده السلف كالبربهاري وغيره من تأليف هذه الرسائل وهذه الكتب في بيان العقيدة الصحيحة.
And this is the intent of those pious predecessors of the past, like Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah and other than him, when they would write and they would compile and compose the likes of these treaties here and their books, they would clarify the correct methodology of al-Islam.
لما حدثت الفتن والافتراقات والضلالات كتبوا هذه العقائد يشرحون بها السنة.
He says, when the tests and the trials came about, and the difference of the separation began, and the dalalat and the affairs of deviation began to creep into among the Muslims, these great imams, they were author and they were right regarding the belief, clarifying and illustrating the sunnah of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. They would clarify the sunnah that the Messenger was upon alayhi salatu wasalam, him and also his companions. And that which those mother preferred and honored generations were upon. Those mother, the path of those that were the preferred generations, those the path that which what? Those that followed it, they transversed upon it, they were successful. And those that turned away from it, they were what? They were destroyed.
التي قال فيها صلى الله عليه وسلم تركتكم على البيضاء ليلها كنهارها.
He says that which the Messenger of Allah said about it, تركتكم على البيضاء ليلها كنهارها إلى آخر هذا الحديث. And which the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, verily I have left you upon البيضاء, that which is extremely clear, its night is as clear as its day, to the end of the hadith.
الله جل وعلا يقول اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا.
And Allah Ta'ala, He says, on this day, translator's note, as it comes in Surah Al-Ma'idah, on this day I have completed for you dinakum, your religion, your way of life. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي, and I have perfected for you my bounty, my blessing. And this is the thing that will bring the Muslims together. This is the thing that will bring اجتماعي الكلمة, that will bring the unification of the Muslims,
توحيد الكلمة,
and will unify the Muslims.
أما أن يقال نجتمع على ما اتفقنا عليه ويعذر بعضنا على ما اختلفنا عليه,
He says, as for the statement that those who say, then let's come together upon that which we agree on, and let's overlook and parting ourselves with regards to that which we differ on, he says, and this is incorrect. He says, but if the differences that we have are differences that come in the aqidah, in the belief, then how can we rectify that?
أما لو كان الاختلاف في الفقه والمسائل الفقهية هذا ربما.
He says, however, yes, if the differences that we have, our aqidah is correct and is the same belief, but we differ in the affairs of al-fiqh or some affairs from the affairs of al-fiqh, then yes, perhaps now this could be correct.
مع أن الواجب اتباع الدليل.
He says, however, it is obligatory to follow the evidence, to follow the proofs. Even in the affairs of al-fiqh, that which is obligatory is to follow the proofs and the evidences. As Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, translator's note, as it comes in Surah An-Nisa, Allah Ta'ala says, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِلَى آخِرِ هَذِي الْآيَةِ. As Allah Ta'ala says, and if you differ amongst yourselves in anything, then refer back to Allah and His Messenger, to the end of this verse.
لكن الاختلاف الفقهي الذي له احتمال ووجه هذا لا يحدث التفرق بين المسلمين.
He says, however, the differences of opinions that take place in the science or in the field of al-fiqh, then this affair here will never bring about separation, will never bring about matter the Muslims being divided, never.
وفيهم الشافعي وفيهم ولم يختلفوا ولله الحمد.
He says, so you find amongst the Ummah of Al-Islam, amongst the people of Ahl Sunnah, you find that this one is Hanafi, this one follows the madhab of Al-Imam Abi Hanifa, and this one is Maliki, he follows the madhab of Al-Imam Malik, and this one is Shafi'i, he follows the madhab of Imam Al-Shafi'i, and this one is Hanbali, he follows the madhab of Al-Imam Ahmed. However, they do not differ. They do not differ. And all praise belong to Allah in this regard. And they do not separate themselves. He says, because these affairs here are from ijtihadatun fiqhiyya. They are based upon the Jewish affairs of being diligent and going after the evidence. He says, and this takes place because of the searching and the research of and the probability of the proofs and the evidences. He says, however, their belief, their methodology was one and the same. He says, the madhab of Imam Ahmed and the madhab of Imam Shafi'i and the madhab of Imam Malik and the madhab of Imam Abu Hanifa, their aqidah is one and the same. He says, although, yes, you do find sometimes those that follow them, that they differ amongst themselves in aqidah. He says, yes, you do find, when you do your investigation and your research, you do find that those that follow the madhab of Al-Imam Abu Hanifa, and those that follow the madhab of Al-Imam Al-Shafi'i, and those that follow the madhab of Al-Imam Malik, you do find amongst them, those who follow them, those who oppose those imams themselves in aqidah, although they claim to follow them. He says, they only attribute themselves to these imams in fiqh only. But with regards to belief, although they claim to follow them, you find that they oppose them in belief. So in reality, these individuals who only follow them in al-fiqh, but they oppose them in aqidah, in reality, they are not followers of these imams. Because in reality, what happens is that they follow them in one regard, and they oppose them in another regard, and that which they oppose them in is more important than what they follow them in. Allahu Akbar. So they follow them in one thing, but they oppose them in something that is more honorable and more important than what they agree with them in or what they follow them in. So these individuals, they are not considered among those who truly follow these imams, because they oppose them in their belief. They oppose them in their belief. He says, so this is what has taken place from the scholars of the past, like Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah and other than him, whereas they have written and composed explaining the path, the correct methodology, the correct path that has been derived and extracted from the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger alayhi salatu salam, upon the methodology and the guidance of the rightly guided predecessors, in order for the Muslims to transverse and to follow upon this.
وهذا وعامتهم.
And in reality, this is from the affair of giving sincere advice to Allah and His Messenger and to His Book and to the leaders of the Muslims and to their common folk.
أما لو كان الأمر خفيا ولم يبين ولم تؤلف هذه المؤلفات لظل كثير من الناس.
So and if the affair was left hidden and unknown or not discussed and not clarified and not authored and not books being written and authored in this regard, then many of mankind would have went astray.
لكن هذه المؤلفات ولله الحمد هذه نعمة من الله عز وجل.
But in reality, the likes of these compilations and all praise belong to Allah in this regard is considered to be a bounty and a blessing from Allah, the Mighty, the Majestic.
وحجة من الله على خلقه.
And is considered to be a proof from Allah upon His creation.
يحيى من حي عن بين ويهلك من هلك عن بين.
He says, as Allah Ta'ala, He says, وَيَحْيَ مَنْ حَيَّ عَنْ بَيِّنَةً. For the one to mather, to rectify and to revise or revive those who are alive, عَنْ بَيِّنَةً, with clarification and knowledge. Surah to Anfal.
الحمد لله الذي هدانا للإسلام ومن علينا به وأخرجنا في خير أمة.
So inshallah ta'ala, we'll stop here as the reader, he read the beginning of Sharh As-Sunnah lil-Imam al-Barbahari. As he says, Imam al-Barbahari, he mentions, Alhamdulillah alladhi hadana lil-Islam wa manna alayna bihi wa akhrajana fi khayri ummatin fa nas'aluhu tawfiqa. And Sheikh Fawzan began to explain, and we'll save that part inshallah ta'ala for the next lesson. He said that the Imam says, all the praise belong to Allah, the one who has guided us to Al-Islam and has blessed us with it and has raised us up or extracted us from the best of the Ummah. And we ask him for success to the end of this particular statement. And we'll stop here. Bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Wa jazakum allahu khayran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.